Sasha Mensch, and I am the Director of Economic and Market Development for Mercy Corps. And that means I support our programming worldwide in any aspect of economic development, market development.
My name is Elliot Levine. I work for Mercy Corps in Portland, Oregon, as part of Mercy Corps' technical support unit that works on environment, energy, and climate change issues. And my focus there is work on climate change adaptation, and in particular, on Mercy Corps' resilience initiative, working to mainstream resilience programming throughout our development programs around the world. Today's presentation was about the links between market systems development and resilience approaches. We focused on drawing out some of the tangible and intangible links between those two approaches, and how, in particular, how market systems development doesn't necessarily lead to resilient outcomes. The major takeaway is that although market systems development and resilience share some common principles, they're not, resilience is not inherent within a market systems development approach. Meaning that if we want market systems development work to contribute to resilience, there are certain things that we need to do. There are certain ways of developing our programs, analyzing the effectiveness of our programs that need to change.
Both market system development and resilience are complex approaches with long time frames. And we may need to think of different approaches to how we work, different time frames, different expectations if we're going to actually reach both market system development and resilience. We can integrate market system development and resilience, but we have to be very deliberate in understanding who we care about, what are the shocks and stresses that affect them, and how market system approaches can improve their resilience. We have to do the analysis. And then we have to keep implementing and assessing to ensure that we're reaching those goals.
One of the other key messages of our presentation today was the fact that in a lot of market systems development programming, we focus a lot on increased productivity and increased income. While those are certainly important contributions to well-being and can have effects on resilience, we need to consider other factors. Other important factors might be the diversification across risk, not just how income is being generated, but is that generation of income being done in ways that are risk-averse, that have different levels of risk to different types of shocks and stresses. And that's important because resilience really comes down to what is your capacity to manage for and prepare for shocks and stresses. So market systems development, if it's going to contribute to resilience, needs to be informed by that framework.